Welcome. In this video, we'll be looking at the direct messaging feature in DrChrono. Direct messaging is a secure way of sending health information over the internet. Sometimes it's just called direct. And direct messaging does need to be set up for both the sender and recipient. So for example, you can set up direct messaging in DrChrono and the person or part of your practice that you're sending the message to through direct messaging also needs to have direct messaging set up on their system as well. So we can't send direct messages to a regular email address. And our partner UpDoc supports our direct messaging, and they also support our faxes as well. So to add direct messaging in your account, you can contact your account manager, implementation specialist, or DrChrono support. Once the feature has been activated on your account, you can go to Account and Account Settings, click on the General tab, and scroll down to the Communications section to get set up. Click on the green Set Up Your Direct Address button, and then you'll need to create a domain. This could be the practice name or company name, and you can put that there. And then click Save, and then click Get Started. And then you'll need to agree to some terms of service and information about the Experian user agreement. So you'll click Agree. You'll enter all the information into the spaces provided, and then click Verify. Now that you've set direct messaging up, you want to be sure that you add the direct message addresses of the people that you're going to be communicating with and sending referrals to. And you could do that under Contacts. And just like with any other contact information here, we'll click New Contact, and you want to enter all the other relevant information. And then here you've got the direct address, so you can put that there and save that information. And once you've done that and you've got the information in there, you'll come here to Outbound Referrals. I'm going to click New Referral, and the next step is to choose the patient. So you can select a recently seen patient or search for one. I'm going to select Jenny Harris here for this appointment. And the next step is to put the contact information in for who you're sending it to. And I'm sending this to myself, so you'll see my direct address there pop up. So we're good to go with that. And you would fill out the referral as you normally would with the relevant information. And you can see there's a little disclaimer there that says electronic transmission enabled, since we have direct messaging set up. And you can include any documents. I'm going to include a couple clinical notes here just so we can see what that looks like once the message has been sent. After you've selected the documents and the referral is complete, you can see there's a direct message button here. We'll click that. And once that's clicked, we can click close, and the message will be visible in our outbound referrals. In the message center, we can see the direct message section. There's outbound and incoming direct messages. And similar to the outbound referrals or outgoing faxes, we can click on that to see what the messages that we've sent. And we can click on the incoming messages to view the messages we've received via direct message. And you can associate the document with a patient chart. If we click on the PDF, we can view this. And the cool thing about direct messaging is if you do a lot with images, you can see that the images will come over with color as well. So if you do a lot with the free draw fields and photo documentation, that's one of the benefits of direct messaging. The direct message will also include CCDA documentation, and you can view the HTML file. So I'll click on this here, and we can view and scroll through the health summary for the patient. And the other file type is an XML file, which you can download. Thank you for taking the time to learn about direct messaging.